Good evening and welcome to ANZ Stadium in Suva, Fiji. It's game three on match day one of the OFC U20 Championship. I'm Gordon Watson, your commentator. I'm joined by co-commentator Indra Singh from FBC. Indra, welcome. And a mouth-watering match before us. It's very difficult to know what to expect from these two teams. Solomon Islands and Papua New Guinea. We've already witnessed Fiji defeating American Samoa by 4-0 and Vanuatu overcoming New Caledonia by 1-0. And as you can see here, there are plenty of supporters for both sides with the university not too far away from the stadium, housing students from all over the Pacific.
May I request you all to be upstanding for the national anthem of the two countries, Solomon first.
Well, if you weren't taken by the show of patriotic fervour by both teams, then you must be made of stone. The look on the faces of Fred Bala and Joachim Kauri, enough to give you goosebumps. These two teams have never met at OFC U20 level before in the 40-year history of this competition. So history being made tonight simply by these two teams taking each other on. Pre-match formalities being taken care of. Of course, the OFC president, David Chung, to the forefront of the picture there with the Fiji FA president, Rajesh.
Yeah, what an exciting encounter in front of us, Gordon. We watched two good games. The first one, Fiji running out 4-0 winners of American Samoa, and then Vanuatu in New Caledonia. Not playing the game we expected, but Vanuatu getting that pretty 1-0 win for the 3 points, which is important in this tournament. And now is the Solomon Islands up against Papua New Guinea. And also, it is very interesting, I was just watching the emotions, and you can see still emotional, the Solomon Islanders in particular, as they with a big support here at the ANZ Stadium in Lodhala. And the players will know that their fans are behind them. It's time for them to deliver. They already know 2 games gone, results in front of them. They need a win to stamp their mark on the opening day, match day one of the OFC Championship. Number 16, Timothy Bunabu.
Well, it's the Solomon Islands' 25th match at this level of competition. They first appeared in the OFC U20 Championship back in 1998. They've got a fairly formidable record, 13 wins, 4 draws, 7 defeats, 71 goals for, 29 against. And for Papua New Guinea, well, they first graced this stage back in 1978. Now, the record hasn't been so impressive. In 32 games, they've won just 3 against Samoa in 1998, the Cook Islands in 2001, and American Samoa in 2011. In those 32 matches, they've also had 3 draws and lost 26 games. But these two teams, as I said previously, have never met at this level of competition. The referees, Ravitesh Bahari of Fiji, Avinesh Narayan and Terry Piri, the assistant referees from Fiji and Cook Islands respectively. And the fourth official is Robinson Banga from Vanuatu.
Gordy, I was just looking at the Solomon Islanders, and I remember just recently, as we look at the upcoming matches, Solomon Islands taking on Vanuatu in a tantalizing clash, 2:30 local time on Sunday. Then it's Papua New Guinea versus American Samoa, and then it's the host Fiji taking on New Caledonia at 7:30 p.m. here at the ANZ Stadium. The standings, as it stands, Fiji on top, 3 points. Vanuatu, 3 points on better goal difference. Fiji on top, PNG and Solomon's in front of us, New Caledonia and American Samoa with a loss each.
So the Solomon Islands have opted for a radical departure under Coach Commons Manapi in terms of their formation. They've gone 4-3-3 with pretty much in the first two games we saw teams opting for 4-4-2. So this is something that's a little bit different from what we've seen. Expect the Solomon Islands to come out firing. They're going to try and throw everything at Papua New Guinea, who have gone for a 4-4-2 in much the same way as the other teams. And this team led by Derek Komalong. There's no David Brown, by the way, the Auckland City player. He's not with this squad. But they have a lot to prove. They had a build-up campaign in New Zealand and it didn't go according to plan. There were some heavy defeats to New Zealand under-20s and a narrow defeat to a New Zealand under-17 select. But that was played in typically wintry conditions. Something of a shock to the system for Papua New Guinea. All that's forgotten. None of it counts. And the phony war, as they say, is over.
Yeah, got in Cummins Manapi as we get underway here at the NZ Stadium. Cummins Manapi, the coach of the Solomon Islanders, he's played here for Nindi and Navua. Gideon Omikoro, who's also on the bench as one of the assistant coaches for the Solomon Islanders, he has played here as well. And what a change for them to be coaching in front of the Fijian public and their own fans here.
Quite right. The coach of Papua New Guinea is Winton Rufer, Oceania Player of the Century. And a former striker with Werder Bremen, of course. He's a big believer in this group, despite what happened in the match with New Zealand. They've beaten 12-1 in a friendly at Onehunga Sports. Solomon's making all the early running. Fell throw by Janelle Kambawal.
How they look up to Nelson Saleh Khalifa, the Amical defender, the captain for Amical, and the Solomon Islands international. James Naka.
Offside flag goes up. Okay, so Obed Kevin plays his football in New Zealand with Nelson.
Yeah, Manapi spoke highly of him in the preview, in the build-up to this tournament. Kevin Obed would be one of his key men for the next 5 match days.
Fred Bowler gets a touch on that. We'll restart with a Papua New Guinea throw. Kambawal. Kambawal again. Well, the Solomon Islands have produced so many top quality players over the years, it's difficult to list them all. Alec Maimai, Benjamin Tatori being just two. James Naka, who Indra mentioned earlier, was a standout for the Solomon Warriors at the OFC Champions League in Lautoka last month. There are sure to be gems in yellow shirts tonight.
Reginald Divani, assistant coach to Winton Rufa. Great name in Pacific football.
Kambawal's throw, hooked clear. Solomons can open up Papua New Guinea here. Abdul Redner provided the cover for Papua New Guinea. Cornel, the goalkeeper. It's incredible to think that a country like Papua New Guinea, with so much experience at this level, has only managed to win three games. It's a nation of untapped potential. 7 million population. And of course, Ikari United provided the high watermark, winning the OFC Champions League 4 years ago, playing at the FIFA Club World Cup. So expect the sleeping giant to awaken over the next couple of seasons, perhaps. They have a chance here to carve something out for themselves. Long-range shot was a poor one. Oh, that deflection's broken nicely. The chance, good save by Philip Mango.
Mango read that well, because but there was an offside flag on the other side, as we see that chance for Papua New Guinea. And it was Simongi.
Fred Bala for the Solomons. Still going. This is a promising move. Kari with the cross. Easy one for Vagi Koniel. ANZ Stadium comes to life each time Solomon Islands play forward. Joachim Cardi's quick, but he's not that quick.
Gotten two games so far. What have you thought of the two matches? In the first, Fiji American Samoa, and then the Vanuatu and Nickeldonians.
Well, two very different matches, I have to say. Fiji were just a little bit too good for American Samoa. They were always in control of that tie. Very difficult to make an assessment, or a true assessment, if you like, of their prospects. Vanuatu and New Caledonia was a match that was filled with drama and tension, but the quality perhaps was lacking. We could attribute a lot of that to first night stage fright, perhaps. But the goal that won it, scored by Justin Coker, was absolutely superb.
A grand goal for a not-so-good game. And that they'll take, as we said, a 1-0 in the next five games will be taken by any of the teams.
Akinkawa's free kick is cleared by Papua New Guinea. They get a second bite of it. through Ayrton Yagas. Well, there's an injured player down in Papua New Guinea's half. And Ravitesh Bahadi spotted that with the help of the assistant referee. He's going to require some attention. He's attempting to get to his feet. I don't think there's any real need for him to rush himself.
Maya ball.
Minton Rufa showing his concern. Komalong trying to set something underway here on the right. Sorry, another touch of the ball for Kunil. It's a Yagas forward ball intercepted, picked up by Bala. That's a great ball. The flag will go up though.
Looking on the other side on the cement embankment, Gotti, the Solomons fans all on their feet, not sitting down, cheering, the flags waving as we see the Solomons bench, looking on. Cummins Manapi there, the coach.
Doesn't want to get caught out here on the ball. He has been. Solomon's guilty of overplaying in their own third. They've coughed up a free kick. This is in a good position for Papua New Guinea. The aerial threat is Derek Komalong, the skipper.
He was here last year as well with the under-20s, Gotti. Was impressive.
Nigel Melangian will take the free kick. Four on the wall for the Solomons. There are six targets for Papua New Guinea in the penalty area. One sitting at the back, and it's in! Papua New Guinea take the lead!
Yagas was at the end of that, heading it in for Papua New Guinea, and this is a grand start for Papua New Guinea.
It's in Yagas has given Papua New Guinea a 1-0 lead. Malangian's free kick and took a deflection off the wall, but where was the marking?
Yeah, the markers went to sleep, the defenders went to sleep, and Solomon Islands gets punished here against all odds, Papua New Guinea. And as we said it earlier on, that result in New Zealand will not count for anything here, as the Papua New Guinea fans all celebrating that goal. Yagas, the hero so far, early, 10th minute.
They've been waiting 3 years for another victory at this level, Papua New Guinea. And they've put a foot forward towards that aim. They can't afford to switch off. They've conceded a corner. Dunstan Kwanafia will take it. There's been a swap there, in fact. It's Timothy Bakale. Perhaps they'll look to play it short to Atkin Kawa. They have taken it short. Into the far post. Poor quality cross. Right idea. The execution not of the quality required.
Yeah, but what a start for Papua New Guinea here at the ANZ Stadium. And everyone takes Solomon Islanders as the favourites. Long way to go in this game, but this was the start that Papua New Guinea would have dreamed about.
Well, they've choked the ball up, Papua New Guinea. They have gone to sleep. There's a long-range shot. Not going to trouble Vangi Cornel. Poor effort from Timothy Bekele. Snatched at it. Well, this Papua New Guinea side suffered through a two-week preparation, losing to New Zealand 12-1. They lost 2-1 to New Zealand in a second fixture. And there were one or two players who came down with an illness. But I bet you they're not feeling the effects of that at the moment as the Solomons look to break. Kambawal, there's a real good feeling about this game. Well, he's overplayed his return pass. Janelle Kambawal, Peter Davinyaba wasn't very happy with him. Number 11. Goal scorer, hoisting the ball forward. Looking for Samongi. Yagas has miscued his clearance. But, Josh Talau has provided some support. So we're in the 14th minute. Solomon Islands 0, Papua New Guinea 1. Well, Papua New Guinea have never beaten a top five side in Oceania before. They've got a one goal lead. Alan Peter for Bala. Nice step inside Davinyaba. Talau. Maya Bob. This is better from the Solomons. By Yagas. Davinyaba. Peter. Bala tried to go through the legs. He got a lucky rebound, Fred Bala, off Davinyaba. That's a nice switch of play. That's an excellent pass.
This Papua New Guinea side has surprised me in these early stages. Not something that we expected. More of a Solomon Islanders, I thought, would be dominating this game. Winton Drufo has done a grand job with these youngsters, bringing them here for this U20 Championships.
Peniel taking his good sweet time about picking the ball up. Not the tallest of goalkeepers, has to be said. Roland Smisitana's clearance is broken kindly for the Solomons. That's a good switch of play. Jojim Kauri's touch deserted him. Pressure off Papua New Guinea for the moment. Cries of go, Solo, go start to echo around ANZ Stadium as the Solomon Islands supporters seek to lift their team not a dire situation by any stretch of the imagination. The goal went in after 10 minutes. Plenty of time to retrieve the situation for Commons Manapi's young team. Rollins Misitana commanding everything at the back for his country. Nice switch of play to bring Bala into the clear, but he's coughed up the ball cheaply. Should really have been looking for Joachim Kadi here on the right. Devin Yaba. Frederick Simongi just switched off for the moment. Didn't see Devin Yaba's clever pass. Took his eye off the ball. Kambawal intercepted. Atkin Kawa. Right idea. Poor execution. Mongasulia gave it away. Kambawal. Bala. Well, that's a good shape from Papua New Guinea. Made it very difficult for the Solomon Islands to play through, and the ball they resorted to was a long one. Misitana. Bala. Tries to pick out a spot between the two centre halves and is rewarded with a throw in.
Good marking by the Papua New Guinea defenders so far in this game. It's not letting the skillful Solomon Islanders get away. As you see, Kambua, Papua New Guinea, number three.
Well, we saw in the OFC Nations Cup just how effective Frank Farina was in giving Papua New Guinea's senior national team the good defensive structure. We're witnessing an under-20 side that's showing signs of improvement from their build-up campaign in New Zealand. Of course, we must remember not to put too much emphasis on that build-up program. There isn't anything quite like the real thing, as they say. And it doesn't get more real than this. Up for grabs, a place at the FIFA Under 20 World Cup, New Zealand 2015.
Joseph Joshua Talau there, getting sandwiched by two Solomon Island attackers. Wins a free kick. O'Neill, the goalkeeper for PNG, quickly takes it. The other aspect is while the tears go up once in a while, the Solomon Island crowd seems to have been stunned by that goal early by Papua New Guinea.
Well played by Anton Yagas. Poor control from Peter Davin Yaba. Atkin Kawa. Well, Papua New Guinea coach Winton Roof will be satisfied with what he's seen so far. Misitana, Bala. Davin Yaba, straight ball to a straight Simongi run. Melangian for Davin Yaba. Given away by Davin Yaba. Can't afford to do that. Mongasulia. Alfie Chacha. Mongasulia again. tried to pick out a teammate on the left. He only managed to find Abdul Redner. Constant Quinafia is taken down. That's a free kick. Abdul Rednett's going to get a talking to here.
The other thing I've gotten so far in the games we've seen is you see the replay of that foul once again. And it was a foul, correctly picked up by the referee. The other thing I was just going to mention is the big names so far haven't really any yellow card there to Papua New Guinea's Redenut. And the big name players in this game, Kevin Obed, we haven't really seen him, as we see Comments Manapi on the screen. And in the prior game, as we were mentioning, the New Caledonian player from Sheffield United. So the two players that are big name players in their respective teams we haven't really seen. Kevin still has got half of this half to go and the second half to prove his worth. Solomon Island is prepared to take this set piece. And we haven't seen a spectacular set piece goal as yet as well in this tournament so far.
No, well, I wonder if there's a routine, a set play about to be unleashed. There's not a lot of height in the Solomon side. The only target really as well is Misitana. Powerful centre-half, but more in the mould of Nelson Saleh than Gideon Omokirio, you might say. Here is a free kick, straight at the keeper. Mangi Conneal goes about his work conscientiously. Well, he's handled the ball outside his own penalty area. The most basic of mistakes.
You look at him go, he's bouncing it, he's bounced it twice. He just stepped out of his box.
Well, it's these types of lapses that could cost.
Marginal call, but yeah, picked up by the assistant referee.
Timothy Bakale standing over it. Vangi Cornel sets his wall. Bakale will like the look of this from this distance. It takes a calm nerve and superior technique to exploit these opportunities. The quality was in evidence there. A let-off for Papua New Guinea and a wasted opportunity for the Solomon Islands.
There's no dip. He did not dip it. He did not time it or where he wanted it. Just straight went right over the crossbar. And Koyneel's goal mouth stays safe.
Up as you'd expect. Alan Peter for Fred Bala. Kinkawa was looking for a forward run from Bala, didn't get it. Kawa trying to measure a ball in to Dunson Quinafia. Got his measurement wrong. Given away. This is where the Solomons are most dangerous on the counter-attack. Quinafia needs some help. Finds it. Wongasulia. Nice switch of play by him. Fred Bala. Still going, Bowler. Can he get a cross in? No, he can't.
He had three to four players in the box and decided to take it on his own. Wasted it after some good build-up work by him. You see Bowler there, wins it, turns away.
Well, what he needed to do was take another touch and aim for that byline, get to the byline and then cut it back. But he rushed his lines and in the end got them completely wrong.
Yeah, Papua New Guinea are giving away a lot of free kicks in the final third. And that's the attacking third for the Solomon Islanders. And one of these could just go in and then it'll be left to Papua New Guinea to ruin the goal that they've scored to lead this game. And I'm pretty sure Winton Rufa will not be happy with that. You see Bakale to deliver this in.
Good delivery. Josh Talo made it in kind with a powerful header. Another cross wound in. Comfortably taken by Cornel. Well, Papua New Guinea mustn't forget to keep playing. As you rightly point out, they've been well worth their one goal lead. But they have stepped back and allowed the Solomon Islands to exploit spaces out wide and get crosses in. There's only so long that that can continue without causing them a problem. And there's a problem developing for Papua New Guinea here.
They're exploiting PNG, they're exploiting, they're getting their chances, but the just final finishing is not there for the Solomon Islanders.
Nice work by Dunstan Quanafia. Spotted Atkin Kawa in space, and Kawa's shot was not very good. Rongasulia lays it off for Misitana. Davin Yaba doing some defending. Lovely play from Papua New Guinea. Well, Winton Rufa really needs more of the same from his team, but further up the pitch. If they can play like that, and the Solomon Islands back third, then they could well get a second goal. But at the moment, they seem to be content just sitting back and inviting the Solomon Islands onto them. And eventually, with the quality that the Solomons have got, something has to give. Headed clear by Allen. Long range shot blocked and it's broken kindly for Malangian.
Should have done better.
Had to be on target. You must test the goalkeeper from that sort of distance. Was Papalau, in fact, with the shot.
Gotti, we mentioned this in one of the games we were doing at the OFC Champions League last month in either Bar or Lautoka. It was where the players, in most of the island players, and we compare them to the teams like Waitakere and Auckland City, they go for power rather than precision, and that has been the downfall for most of these players. And we've seen that in the games that have played so far here as well with the Under-20 Championships.
Yeah, we were talking in an earlier commentary about, come back to that. Lovely footwork. There's a shot. Dunstan Quanafia.
Quanafia has been impressive on the left.
He has. He does like to cut in and shoot with his right foot. That's something that Papua New Guinea need to be careful of. Now, Papua New Guinea have robbed the Solomon Islands of the ball in their own third, but despite Komolong's interference, Manawa have come away with it. Well, both teams guilty of giving away possession cheaply. Bala. Good strength shown by Obed Kevin. And a good ball. Jochen Kari has got Quanafia in the middle. It's a goal kick.
Just looking at Quanafia making that run off the ball, trying to create some space for himself in the penalty box. Quanafia has been good. It's just that final ball not coming to him, and when it does come to him, sometimes the finish hasn't been there. But if he keeps on trying, this Papua New Guinea defense could be in the danger of conceding. And that's what Winton Rufa will be trying to tell them, to tighten it up, in particular on the left, and it is the right of the PNG defense.
So we're in the 32nd minute. Solomon Islands 0, Papua New Guinea 1. Goal scored by Ayrton Yagas after 10 minutes. Just to illustrate how difficult things have been for Papua New Guinea at this age group level, they've played Tonga 3 times in this competition and they've lost twice. Them. They've also had defeats against the likes of Samoa, and when you consider the talent that they've had at their disposal, it does seem rather like they've underachieved. This is going back a few decades, mind. It's come along. Yagas. Nice ball by Bala. Looking for Kwanafia. Well, both players turned their back on it, and the ball bounced in the end. Papalawa Wele looking for Samongi. That's a difficult one. Peter Allen's cope, though. Bala will have to do some defending against Davinyaba. Step over. Second touch was a bit heavy. Davinyaba trying to backheel. Corner. That's a poor one from Bala. Now, this is where Papua New Guinea can cause an aerial threat. Through Komalong, Yagas, Malangian. Well, Malangi will take the corner, so that takes him out of the picture. Indra mentioned earlier, as you can see from the corner flag, there is a breeze blowing from the seaward side of the stadium. Malangian takes the corner, it's out to the edge of the D. The volley's a weak one. Camberwell's actually done quite well there, even if it looked ungainly. Davinyaba taken out. Papua New Guinea starting to look dangerous here. Awele, still going Awele. Oh, it's not far away. But it's not on target either.
Awele, that's his second chance that he's had, and he's again gone for power rather than precision. He's not hitting the target.
Here you see the first touch was decent. Second gets around his defender between the centre half and the left back. The shot was a poor one. Frederick Samongi throws the goalkeeper off his line. Philip Mango. Well, Solomon's just on the ropes here. Kwanafia. Kawa. Good challenge from Komalong. Complete miscue. Play continues. Kwanafia pops up on the right-hand side. He's got Bala for support here on the right. If he can find him, which he can't. Nice turn from Misitana. Allen. Now Bala's onside. There's an unmarked player at the far post if he can pick him out. Well, he can't. In fact, he had 3 targets to hit. Yes. He timed his run perfectly.
Something with Bala we've seen is he's done some really good things, but his just final ball, he's been a bit selfish, trying to take it himself. This time he had about 3 in the box. Far post, the Solomon Island attacker was all by himself.
Quite right, he has timed some of his runs beautifully down this right-hand side. His first touch is usually pretty good. It's the final touch that hasn't been quite up to the mark. Nigel Malangian chasing it down. Bala gets a touch. This is a nice piece of play by Kawa. And then he lets himself and his team down with a final pass. Dunstan Quanafia, who started the match on the left, now popped up on the right. Joachim Cowdy has gone across to take up Quanafia's previous beat. We're in the 37th minute. Solomon Islands 0, Papua New Guinea 1. The road to New Zealand 2015, well underway.
What a World Cup that will be. Will be played in New Zealand. We saw a successful Rugby World Cup. We have the Junior Rugby World Cup. It's for, and for the beautiful game to take place in New Zealand. So look at the foul. It was Fred Bala.
Good jump from Allen. Put on by Bolasulia. That's a good ball. And the Rednet made the interception for Papua New Guinea. They've got a throw midway in Solomon Islands territory. Good touch by Quanafia. Manages to get the ball through. He's onside. Final ball from Obed Kevin. Too closely resembles many of the other crosses we've seen from the Solomons tonight. He's bent his run really, really well. He takes the centre half out wide, but it was neither a cross nor a shot. Derek Comalong. Lovely work from the skipper. Well, Quanafia has space. Can he deliver a cross of quality? It's not a bad one. Great defending. Superb defending.
I'd like to see this replay because I thought the first look was the goalkeeper and the defender collided with each other, but the referee has called for a free kick. See, Quanafia comes into the cross. Interesting, but yeah, again, Quanafia creating problems on this right-hand front side now.
Well, the way I saw that one, Indra, was Abdul Rednet winning the header. It's a really awkward one for a left-back to deal with. He's got his back to his opponent. All the power of the ball is directed towards his own goal, and he's got to somehow try and bend his neck around that and hit it clear, which he managed to do. Here is Rednet. Picks out Derek Comalong, the skipper. Awele for Rednet, intercepted by Peter Allen. Now the Solomons can break. Dunstan Quanafia down this right-hand side against Janelle Kambawal. Has he got a cross, though? He doesn't. Well, not one that's targeted at a yellow jersey. Look at the passion piece shown by Vangi Conneal.
I think Comments Manapi at halftime will not be so much worried about that 1-0 lead that PNG has against his team, or rather his defense, but it'll be that final ball. All the opportunities they are creating, the final ball just does not seem to be going where he would want it to.
Quite correct. They're getting into the right spaces. It's down to quality. If the Solomon Islands can recalibrate their crossing, then things don't look so bad. But the more often they get into these wide positions and then miscue their crosses, the less pressure there is on Papua New Guinea. They have to ask more searching questions of this Papua New Guinea defence. If they get the supply line right, then they can score goals. If they don't get it right, well, it's just that much harder. Good ball. Excellent ball by Davinyaba. Simongi. Tidied up by Bala. Mango. Alfie Chacha. Dunstan Konafia likes to get away from his marker. He's tried to go by the left back, and Papua New Guinea have the free kick go their way.
Konafia is like one of those short and small and but nuggety, just like the halfbacks in rugby would say. He just likes to get in there. They just had a word with the Papua New Guinea defenders. Gave away a free kick, but he does make those runs. He does like to run at the defenders, and the balls that are coming through to him on the left when he was on the left and now on the right are good balls. But again, that final ball that is making the difference for the Solomon Islanders and leaving PNG in the lead heading into halftime.
Konafia. This time tracking inside. Lovely footwork from him. Well, the numbers were building up. Out wide for the Solomons, and they've got three unmarked at the far post. That's if they can get this ball right. And they can't quite find themselves a position to cross from. Goodness me. Joachim Kari popped up on the left.
If in boxing terms the PNG team is on the ropes, they're getting beaten and beaten, but they're still on their feet, not conceding defeat. That's the way it is. They're not conceding that goal as yet.
Well, it's defending like that that's helping them out, and the Solomon Islands' wastefulness from wide positions. But they are digging deep. They're showing great reserves of character and strength, Papua New Guinea. Yagas misses it. Konafia cuts inside. The space here for him to run at the defence. Chose the wrong option.
Bakali goes down in front of his supporters on the far side. A foul committed by Redmond.
Well, it's like a concrete Lawson Tubber Stadium over there. Solomon supporters have made that section of the venue their own. And that's something to smile about before half time. Oh, it's at the crossbar. Wanga Kuniel might have got a glove on it as well. It's going to be a corner. That's what referee Ravitesh Bihari believes anyway. Another look at it again. Well, I'm not so sure that he did get a glove on it. So it really shouldn't be a corner, but that's the decision. Dunstan Konafia will take it. Changes his mind.
Went to will they go short? Short. Not happy with his defenders.
What a time this would be for the Solomons to equalise. Aimed to the edge of the box, it's miscued. Good defending from Papua New Guinea again. Well, injury, you get the distinct feeling that if Papua New Guinea are to get all 3 points here, they're going to have to get a second goal, because one doesn't look as though it'll be enough.
Because the Solomon Islanders are gaining momentum. They've just been very, very lucky, the Papua New Guineans, and the Solomon Islanders unlucky not to have got that equaliser.
So halftime at ANZ Stadium in Game 3 on Match Day 1 of the OFC U20 Championship. Solomon Islands trail Papua New Guinea by goal to nil. Let's look at the highlights of the first half.
Yeah, that was in the fourth minute. Chimongi laid it in, and Oile got a grand save there by Philip Mango, Solomon Islands goalkeeper. In the 10th minute, this is when the goal came.
Solomon Islands just getting caught in possession here. The free kick was given. was a good free kick. Took a deflection off the wall. And Ayrton Yagas puts it in the back of the net. But look at the lack of marking. There was nobody within touching distance of the Papua New Guinea centre half. And he couldn't help but put it in the back of the net.
They like that corner, don't they? Every celebration is going towards that corner.
Seems that everybody's trying to get as close to Reiwa as they possibly can after scoring. Solomon Islands, though, created plenty of opportunities to cross from wide positions, but this was the problem. Not so much beating the defenders, but just finding some quality in the crossing. Fred Barlett, who's had an outstanding game in the sense that he's timed his runs pretty well, has shown the flip side of that coin by struggling to get the ball into the back of the penalty area. Dunstan Quinafia has been very impressive. Nice touch here. Runs at the defence, cuts in onto the right foot. Shot straight at the goalie.
34th. Again, Papua New Guinea getting a chance to double their lead. Great play there by the Papua New Guineans. But again, it's power rather than precision. And that has been the downfall. If not, they would have maybe got that second goal that they wanted. And again, it was Owele. He missed two in the first half. In the 39th, again, Quinafia popping up on this side. Slipping and sliding, yet getting his feet. But again, that final ball, not to where he would have wanted it. Quinafia has been impressive with Fred Bala for the Solomon Islanders, but that's their final ball.
So confirmation then that halftime here at ANZ Stadium, it's Solomon Islands 0, Papua New Guinea 1. Rejoin us shortly for the second half. Welcome back to ANZ Stadium. We're just about ready for the start of the second half of the match between the Solomon Islands and Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea lead by a goal to nil. And Indra, your thoughts for what we can expect in the second half?
Yeah, Gordon, great game seen in the first half, one of the faster games of the first half compared to the other two games. But yes, definitely Solomon Islands need to get their house in order as we look at Papua New Guinea about to make a double change. And Solomon Islands need to get these crosses right. They need to get the finishing in order if they really do want to get something out of this game. And we see Isaac Lalo for Papua New Guinea, number 7, about to come in. And also number 10, Stephen Inia. A double swap by Winton Rufa.
Interesting decision. I wonder if this has been forced on Winton Rufa.
Very interesting. 7 and 10 are in. They haven't shown the cards of who has come out.
Well, we'll have to do some investigating for you to try and figure out which players have been withdrawn by Papua New Guinea. So Frederick Simongi and Maya Bob poised to restart. Well, it's fairly clear that Isaac Lalo has popped up on this right-hand side. So Papalau Awele is one of those players who has come off.
Yeah, just looking at number 10 there up in the striker's position with Simongi starting. So it looks like Bob is off.
So very attacking substitutions made by Papua New Guinea. Perhaps Winton Rufa looked at things in the first half and decided that his team indeed has to start trying to spend more of its time in Solomon Islands' half rather than allowing them to come on top of them in numbers. Counter-attack. Chacha's throw. Sulia for Chacha. And Sulia again surveys his options. Goes wide to Peter Allen. A bit more patience being exhibited by the Solomons. There's that ball forward for Bala. Good defending. It was Lalo. There's a long range shot, takes a deflection safely into the hands of the goalkeeper. Abdul Rednet given away. Well, Alfie Chacha guilty of a poor touch.
Yeah, they wouldn't have counted when the shot comes in. Player in the offside position as you watch the replay.
Chacha has options inside. He's picked out Misitana. Now Allen. Bekele. Poor ball by Bekele. Just goes to show that the structure to this Papua New Guinea side is actually quite good. The Solomons have had the ball for long periods and they do tend to want to force the final pass. And for each wayward pass, it just takes a little bit less or a little bit more pressure off Papua New Guinea, the team who currently lead by a goal to nil. Here's Alfie Chacha. Again, the delivery was not good. And Solomons have picked up the second phase ball.
They're called the Brazilians of the Pacific, but not with the kind of play we've been seeing from the Solomon Island Juniors here today as PNG now come on attack. A good defending there by Solomon Islands, and Winton Rufa would want another goal at least put more pressure and make his side comfortable.
Taken out. This could be a card. It's definitely a free kick. I don't think there's any arguments there. Josh Tarlow, centre half, gets a talking to. No more. Demands Ravitesh Bihari. Timothy Bakale fancies this. Four-man wall is set. Mangi Cornel ready on his line, on the balls of his feet. Solomons have five at the back post. The runs begin. It's set up. There's a shot.
So wasted effort once again by the Solomon Islanders. They've got about four free kicks in good positions, including the one where the goalkeeper gave away a free kick by stepping out of the box. And here we see they want to play a short one quickly. Nowhere near the target.
Kick for the Solomons, taken quickly, trying to keep the momentum rolling in their favour.
Good to hear the goalkeeper calling out. Go ahead, Neil.
Bala tried to step in and win the ball back. It's had a positive effect. Panafia, that's a better cross. The goalkeeper takes it well. Under pressure. Chacha's missed it totally. Samongi has taken one in the head. I think he's overcooked.
Alfie Chacha has made two blunders already in the second half.
Yes, he does look liable to a slip every now and then, Alfie Chacha. Philip Mango organises his defence, as you see Gideon Omokiri at the bottom of your picture there. Sending the substitutes to warm up. Well, the marking was poor when Ayrton Yaga scored. Oh, and that's a good effort.
Ooh.
It's in. Papua New Guinea have a goal. They lead by 2-0. An error by the skipper, Philip Mango. And the upset is on the cards. Papua New Guinea closing in on just their fourth ever victory at this level.
Maya Bob slipped to the goalkeeper's hands and straight into the goal.
Well, we talked about the importance of that second goal. They've now got it.
Goal for Papua New Guinea.
Maya Bob.
Maya Bob and the Papua New Guinea bench just jumped, and there's a long shot taken there by Solomon Islands straight for kickoff. This will put the island, Solomon Islands team under a lot of pressure, because PNG with the tails up 2-0, this is what they wanted, to hold that comfortable lead. 1-0 was a danger. 2-0, it's going to be to score twice or score three times to get the win. And it's going to be very tough for the Solomon Islanders, the way they've been playing. And again, against the wind, the free kick was taken. And the breeze definitely is not in their favor, PNG, but they got that free kick. A mistake by Philip Mango, the captain.
Well, space starting to open up all over the pitch for Papua New Guinea. They're treating the ball thoughtfully. Solomon Islands now have to find some way to come back. They're chasing the game.
Oh.
somewhat unlucky not to get a free kick there, Stephen Anissa.
If you look at it in athletics terms, it was a 100-metre sprint, just became a 200-metre race for Papua New Guinea, or rather Solomon Islands. Papua New Guinea would be enjoying this 2-0. And what a difference build-ups and proper preparation makes. You see, as we mentioned at halftime, we're talking at halftime, PNG is showing a different character here at the ANZ Stadium tonight.
Could run this. Still going. Well, the Solomons want to try and stick as closely to their structure as possible. There wasn't too much wrong with how they were playing in the first half. It was just that one element, the final ball. If they're going to start wandering off the page and trying to do things individually or on their own, to their own song sheet, then the chances of winning this game or even retrieving a draw or a point are going to disappear. Misitana. We were talking earlier about players who come off. I suspect it was Nigel Malangian.
Yeah. We thought it was Maya Bob, but Maya Bob was the one who took that free kick that slipped through the gloves of Philip Mangle.
So Stephen Anissa is sitting in midfield now with Derek Komalong. Long range shot over the bar. Vangan Cornel thought enough of it to pull out a dive.
We've heard some. Well, leaving the first game aside, Gordon, Fiji beating American Samoa by 4 good goals. The second and the third game that's in front of us now, some could class it as an upset. Vanuatu beating Nicaledonia. Nicaledonia tagged as one of the top bets. And now Papua New Guinea having that 2-0 lead over the Solomon Islands.
Well, look, things get decidedly more promising for Papua New Guinea. They play American Samoa next.
Yeah.
5 o'clock on Sunday here at ANZ.
Yeah, I was just thinking of that. If Fiji and Papua New Guinea meet on Tuesday here at the ANZ at 2:30 local time, could see two teams with 6 points clashing early. Usually we see them clashing later on in the stages, group stages.
Solomons win the ball back. That's a good ball throw chance. Oh, it's taken a deflection and the goalkeeper, Cornel, clambers all over it.
Solomon Islands, they tasked, as we see, watch the replay. A good ball there. Kyrie.
Yellow card for Derek Komalong. They don't want to get involved in silliness off the ball.
Solomon Islands is up against Vanuatu on Sunday.
That could turn into an absolute must win for both teams. Well, more for the Solomons if this result endures.
They need to create something special from set pieces like this if they want to get back into this match.
That's a good ball. Good defending. You have to hand it to the centre half. He did very well. That was a much better delivery into the box. It's that type of quality that the Solomons should draw upon. Nice work. Goal kick. Well, as this Papua New Guinea performance has unfolded, they've grown in confidence, and you can see that a lot of the principles that have been passed on to them over the last few weeks have started to emerge. They look like a team with good team spirit, a lot of self-belief.
Timothy Bunabo about to come in for the Solomon Islands, number 16. Kunafia has been quiet in the second half.
Good turn from Bala. Again, Can't link up his pass. Papua New Guinea on the break. This is Stephen Inia, has a look around. Decides to take the ball on.
Pulling off Alfie Chacha. Number six.
No surprise there, I think, from either of us. Timothy Bonabo comes on.
Substitution for Solomon Islands, player number six, Alfie Chacha, replaced by player number 16, Timothy Bunam.
Similar position of the last free kick that resulted in the goal.
Indeed it is. I think with this free kick, though, that they're going to try and wind this into the far post rather than shoot. Although you never know. Here it comes. This time, Philip Mango gets both hands on that ball and clasps it. It's Bala. Bonabo's first touch of the ball. That's a good ball too. Josh Talau with some excellent defending. Look at this ball from Bonabo, it's perfect. Spotted the run, got the flight right, got the pace right. And Atkinkawa couldn't match Josh Talau's touch.
Yeah, the Papua New Guinea centre-halves, as you've mentioned as well during the duration of the game, they've been impressive. Just those final touches, final covering tackles, final defence has worked out for them. Don't think the message got through to them at half-time that the final ball by Solomon Islands needs to be better.
No, your strikers can't score goals if they're getting service of that type of quality. Winton Rufa will be more than happy with what he's seeing here from his team. Sitana. Bakale. Peter. Bala. Loses the ball. On halfway. But they have it back. Well, that's a clear foul. I don't think there's any arguments there. Now, a yellow card. That's a foul there, no doubt about it.
Well, sort of some young, hot and headed, hot blooded and hot headed players meeting each other.
Manapi has plenty to think about. His team trailing Papua New Guinea by 2-0. I think too many people foresaw this scoreline. Perhaps based more on reputation than reality, nevertheless. Solomon Islands have a proud history in this competition. They've beaten New Zealand before. Long range shot over the bar, but not by much. Atkinkawa worked himself into a bit of space, took two touches, and had a go. It wasn't far off. Papua New Guinea planning a substitution as well. We're 64 minutes in. Solomon Islands 0, Papua New Guinea 2.
Yeah, he's the fourth official is having a word with his referee about Winton Rufa. And coming in will be for Papua New Guinea.
Well, it would appear to me that Winton Rufa is in a spot of bother here. The last thing that the coach wants is to get sent off, particularly when his team's on a growth curve like this. Derek Comalong, Maya Bob, interesting ball. Goalkeeper comes for it, takes it.
Dallas Namuesh about to come in, number 17 for Papua New Guinea.
Well, since the second goal was scored, the Solomon Islands have just dropped down a notch. Confidence has taken a knock. Well, Nigel Malangian. It's coming off, and Dallas Namuesh.
Substitution for Papua New Guinea, player number 12, Nigel Malangian, replaced by player number 17, Dallas Namuesh.
Kevin Obed for Solomon Islands has been a lost figure in this game. I haven't even heard his name in the second half, Roddy.
No, and I think we can put that down directly to the type of service he's been given. Again, another example of it. Can't get to the byline. Crossing from an awkward position. If you get 10 opportunities to cross in a match and you can get 8 of them into the box with some quality, then Obed Kevin suddenly becomes a bit more of a relevant figure in the game. But when the ratio is a lot lower, then you have to ask questions. Not even Commons Manapi himself could flourish under those sorts of mathematics. Kawa. Longasulia. Misitana for Peter. Fast footwork from Papua New Guinea. Inia. Bob for Rednet.
Skill.
Bonabo. Well, that's the right idea.
Wrong execution.
Exactly. So just a reminder that on Sunday we have 3 more matches on the road to New Zealand 2015 to bring you. 2:30 p.m. Solomon Islands taking on Vanuatu. 5 p.m. Papua New Guinea up against American Samoa. And 7:30 p.m. the host nation Fiji take on New Caledonia. Good work. But again, Dunstan Kwanafia can't get the cross in.
And the net has, that shot apparently has opened the net up from the back of the goalpost. It needs some fixing. As you see the Kwanafia shot, there you go. There.
And just ripped it. Tore the rigging away from the crossbar. Opportunity for the players to take on some refreshments. as we said about repairing the goal.
Reminds me of the 94 World Cup when the crossbar was broken.
Yes. One of those things in football that can happen. There is the problem. Goal net torn away from the upright.
Well, he could say that he did tear the net at the Under 20 Championships.
Yes, but from side on via a goal kick, it's not quite...
not the from the angle he would have wanted.
No, the same boastful talking point that you could...
Yeah, but Papua New Guinea impressive here tonight against all odds. A lot of pundits were talking about Fiji, the Solomons, New Caledonia, Vanuatu. And they were not really putting Papua New Guinea. If you rank them, it was Fiji, Solomons, Vanuatu, and New Caledonia. Then maybe Papua New Guinea and American Samoa. And Winton Rufa himself had said in an interview, could have been mind games, but he did say that the other teams would start as favorites. His team is here to learn. But they have shown us tonight they've learned a lot in the past 2 weeks or so and the times they've been in camp in PNG.
Well, that's the net that Justin Coker scored his goal for Vanuatu. And he gave that a fair old amount of power.
They need to look for the grounds person to come and repair the net. The Solomons fans looking worried.
Well, I think both Reggie Devani and Winton Rufa will be concerned by this break. They don't want the momentum to stop, and it's stoppages like this in football that can break the concentration, particularly of young age group teams. And Papua New Guinea, 2-0 up, they're on top. The last time I remember a rigging taking a hammering in a World Cup qualifier, it cost Australia a place at a World Cup when they played Iran. They were leading 2-0 at the MCG. A fan ran onto the pitch, threw himself into the net, destroyed the net. It took them some 9 minutes or so to fix it. And then when play restarted, Iran scored twice.
And knocked them out.
And knocked them out of the World Cup.
Yeah, that's the thing, the momentum, surely. Solomon Islands would be the benefit here. Papua New Guinea could lose that momentum that they've got going in the last, well, already about 3 or 4 minutes in the added time. They'll have some stoppage time in this match now. Winton Rufa barking out the instructions.
Well, this is key. This is a key moment in the match. In fact, whatever length of time we have for the delay, Winton Rufa is going to try and keep his players focused on the job at hand. It still doesn't look ideal.
Fans braving the chilly conditions here, as we see Cummins Menapi, Gideon.
There's plenty of exciting talent in that Solomon Islands group as we view over the shoulder of Robinson Banger, the fourth official. Been very impressed with Dunstan Kwanafia. Joachim Kadi at different times, more so in the first half. Attacking Janil Kambawal down the right-hand side looked exciting, but again, it was always the quality of the ball being knocked in.
well, some excitement here tonight.
Yeah, needs must as the devil rides. The tape is being provided. I'm not so sure about the occupational safety and health at this moment, but nevertheless, what's important is that the rigging is fixed.
It was amazing. Cummins Menapi and Gideon when they first saw the stadium earlier this week, I do believe, then they said, what happened to the old one they played on?
Yes.
Cummins played for Nauvoo and Nendi and for the Solomon Islands, I believe, on this pitch, or the old pitch here. Gideon was playing here as well for one of the local teams.
It's an amazing venue, and certainly if what we hear is correct, that Churchill Park in Lautoka is going to undergo a facelift that will leave it having more in common with ANZ Stadium here in Suva than it presently does perhaps with a venue like Govan Park. In fact, imagine if Govan Park was to follow in the footsteps of these two stadiums.
Yeah, this is the best facility at the moment in Fiji.
There is Rajesh Patel of the Fiji FA, the president, alongside Bob Kumar, the CEO.
The players need taping. The post gets a taping as well. And we're ready to roll.
Well, the Solomon's flag still flying proudly.
Ball that's been used here at the championship. Was first introduced the OFC Champions League.
That's correct. Don't forget the Oceania Football Confederation does have its own line of apparel. You can take a look at the selection available to you at www.ofcshop.com.
Minutes, roughly, give or take, at a time.
Interesting to see how both these teams react to that break.
Well, it's a Friday evening here in the capital, in Fiji, Suva, the capital of Fiji Islands. And it's the night where everybody enjoys the sports and social gatherings. And then tomorrow is Saturday. Basically, most of the official things, such as the government departments, etc., are closed. And it's also sporting. A lot of rugby and football games underway. And the Under-20 Championships is the major draw card this weekend in the capital. And then Sunday we'll be back here at the ANZ Stadium to have three good games. And the winners will be smiling heading into that game. The losers, a lot of soul-searching for the next, at least a day before they run onto this pitch again on Sunday afternoon.
Indra, I understand the draw for the Fiji Fact was also made two pools of four.
That was done last night. The tournament to be played at Ratu Thakombau Park in Nasori, about 30 minutes from here. Two weekends of 90-minute games, three match days pool games, and then you have the semi-final and the final. And all the other 20 players we saw in the Fijian side, majority of them will be featuring for the districts. It was amazing. We counted that the Bar and Suva players dominate the Fijian under-20 team.
One target in the box to hit. Oh, it's a good cross. The header just wide. Well, the Solomon Islands could replicate that. They might not be trailing 2-0. It wasn't 100% perfect. Cross was excellent. The header off target. But still, the principal in action.
I was just going to mention Komalong, apart from that pass, he's been a good leader for this PNZ team.
Yes, Derek Komalong has been really valuable in breaking up that attack, because don't forget, Solomon sometimes play with four up, with Atkin Kawa just sitting in behind Obed Kevin. And Derek Komalong has been able to choke that supply line. So more running repairs underway for for both teams, it seems.
Welly, the captain, what must be going through his mind? Philip Mengel, the second goal that slipped through his gloves.
Yes, clear goalkeeping error.
It's been a long day, three games here at the ANZ Stadium. Start of the OFC Under 20 Championship, the road to 2015 in New Zealand, the World Cup.
Yes, that's right, that tournament kicks off May the 30th next year, runs through until June the 20th. Well, that's not a bad effort. We've been hugely critical of the quality of crossing that's gone in there, but that was a cheeky effort from Fred Buller using the outside of his right boot. Attempted to catch Vangi Koniel out at his near post. He's conceded a corner. Numbers forward now for the Solomons. Oh, an opportunity. There's a scramble in there. Long range shot, deflected. Appeals for a handball, rather half-hearted. And ball ends up with the goalkeeper eventually.
Also some talks while we take a break here of Wellington Phoenix might be touring the islands next before the next season. The talks underway, particular Fiji, you got it?
Well, that's an interesting development. Obviously with Roy Krishna, part of the Wellington Phoenix,
and
signing a contract.
This will be
extension.
A perfect place for them to play on. Perfect pitch, great facility.
Look, any team from the Fine Day A-League would love to play on that surface. I had a chance to walk over it myself before the matches got underway today, and there's no excuses for any player on this surface. It's perfect for football, as I understand it. There's been no rugby here for 2 months or so.
Yeah, close to 2 months, no rugby. And gone are the days, 2003 South Pacific Games, as it was known at the time, and Fiji beat New Caledonia. It was a rainy night, and the pitch was flooded at times because of the heavy downpour, as Alamasi led Fiji to the victory. To the second ever SPG gold medal. And gone are those days when water would fill up on the pitch and you got to look around for the drain to drain it out. Now, no matter what the weather conditions are, the pitch stays perfect.
That's a good ball. Corner for the Solomons. Just over 15 minutes to go of normal time. There's going to definitely be quite a few minutes additional time played because of the stoppages for the damage to the goal net at the scoreboard end of the stadium. Arla's corner.
Wasted.
It's been the story of the evening for the Solomon Islands, unfortunately.
Can feel the pace of the game slowly dying down after that 10-minute break or so that we had. Both the teams, not particularly PNG, were dominant over Solomons at that stage, but now it seems like just running out of steam.
Not a great free kick. Goalkeeper's missed it though. Oh, how close was that? Solomon's all over the place. Papua New Guinea have a corner as their reward. Mango came for it, but there was no communication between he and Misitana. And it was only the intervention of Alan Peter that prevented the ball ending up in the back of Solomon's net for the third. And Mango's missed it off the line.
Lucky, lucky save there for Solomon Islands.
Well, could easily have been three.
The captain hasn't played a captain's role here tonight. One mistake, and now I've seen him make a few errors as well in the past 2 minutes.
Papua New Guinea can't heap further pressure on the Solomons with that type of a corner.
And what great news to have West Ham and also Newcastle visiting New Zealand later on this year as well.
That's right, in July. They travel to New Zealand to take on Sydney FC and the Wellington Phoenix. Those matches dotted all around New Zealand. We'll come back to that, though. There's an opportunity, hits the bar. Well, that sums it up for Commons Manapi's youngsters, Fred Bala. That was a lovely ball in from Atkinkawa. First touch from Bala was good. The second did enough to beat the goalkeeper. Vangi Kuniel was rooted to the spot. He didn't even bother moving for it.
You know what they say, the goalkeeper's best friend in any game is the goalpost, and they've helped Kuniel twice in this match already.
Timothy Bonabo gets a talking to. Substitute. So if this scoreline stays the same, Papua New Guinea will sit second place in the competition standings at the end of match day one, behind Fiji. Vanuatu will be third, New Caledonia fourth, Solomons will be fifth, and American Samoa, perhaps as many suspected, will be sitting sixth.
It's not like Solomons hasn't had the chances to score in this game and be in the match. It's just through the, as you see, another attack by the Solomon Islanders. Sheer wasting of possession and the final ball that has seen them being down in this game by two goals.
Well, Owele was relying purely on athleticism to get him past the Solomons defence. He's going to require a lot more than that. Here he goes again. Gets a free kick. Third for Papua New Guinea would serve their interests well. Goalkeeper's missed it again, off the line. Well, Philip Mango let off the hook. And the Solomons come up with something. They've got numbers here on the left. They've cut back inside. Good save.
Grand save there by
Wonderful save.
O'Neill.
Margie Conneal distinguishes himself. Look at this. Plenty of power, it was accurate. And the goalkeeper was fully up to the task.
That has been the downfall of the Solomon Islands. We don't need to describe it. You could have seen it yourself, what they delivered in that final ball. That has been the biggest downfall for the Solomon Islanders tonight. They've done some brilliant things in this game. They've created some great opportunities, but they haven't been able to finish it off. As much as the PNG centre defence has been good, Solomon Islands, if they really relook at this game, they could say they led to their own downfall here this evening. 7 minutes. You're showing it very early.
Showing it extremely early. So a minimum of 7 additional minutes, as we understand
seven
it.
7 minutes of additional time shown by both of Sean Robinson.
Dunstan Quinafi has led a lonely figure in the second half as the Solomon Islands performance has unravelled somewhat.
Yeah, they'll be taking out Joachim Kyrie, and coming in will be number 5, Misitana Samani.
Vangi Kunil has had a wonderful game for Papua New Guinea, but what I like about him is that he never stops talking. He just looks so absolutely pumped and motivated every time he's called upon to act in this game. Well, Papua New Guinea now starting to find gaps. That's a useful ball. Offside. Joachim Kari is off. Misitana Samani in. Oh, lovely interchange of passes. Play breaks down. It's with Kunil. Well, that's not a great kick by Kunil. Comalong's managed to get something on it. Bala. Opportunity for the Solomons. When it's not your night, it's not your night.
Yeah, again, great opportunity there for Okawa, but way off target. Just trying to get it out of the stadium, looks like.
Well, some of the Solomon Island supporters have also voted with their feet. have started to leave the stadium. Well, yellow card for Samani.
Just came on.
Ravitesh Bihari spotted a little kick out, I think, aimed in the direction of Awele. Measured ball into the penalty area, repelled by the Solomon Islands. This is where they're strongest on the counter-attack. Well, that's a shove. He's perhaps rather fortunate not to get booked. Frederick Simongi. Bakale plays it wide for Obed Kevin, who's been largely anonymous this evening. Timothy Bakale trying to work those channels just in behind the fullbacks again. Well, it's good to see that adherence to the values of fair play. Game played in very good nature, not quite the same as the frantic, frenetic energy that we saw in the game between Vanuatu and New Caledonia earlier this evening. Well, there is the full-time whistle. Papua New Guinea have been well worth their victory tonight. They've defeated the Solomon Islands by 2-0. And I don't think there can be any argument whatsoever about this result.
Now, in the 51st minute, we saw they took that 1-0 lead into the halftime breather in the second half. Solomon Islands came out trying to look for that the cross coming in, but a good take by the goalkeeper, Koneil. The Papua New Guinean goalkeeper had a good game. Continuously talking, continuously guiding his defenders. Great take there by Koneil. 51st minute. Again, well played by Papua New Guinea. Cleared away by the Solomon Islanders. There was a free kick given away. And this is the one. Delivered. Philip Mango. A crucial, crucial blunder there by Philip Mango. Resulting in the second goal. As you see that brilliant shot there. He tried to hold it. Could have done better to tap it over the crossbar to be on the safer side. They just flapped at it and slipped through his gloves right into the back of the goal for that second goal for Papua New Guinea.
Well, you could see the body language of the Solomon Island players when that ball hit the back of the net. I think they knew then that the game was up. 62 minutes. And this long-range shot just over the crossbar, but not by much at all. Akinkawa Vagi Corneille respected this effort enough to make sure that he got somewhere near it in case it dipped beneath the crossbar. Then in 69 minutes, Awele managed to beat his marker, gets this cross in. The header was an awkward one in truth. The player was unmarked, but it was an awkward one and just couldn't get it on target.
Yeah, 78th minute, a great chance here for Solomon Islands to pull one back, but the shot hits the crossbar and goes out. That's been the downfall for the Solomon Islanders, the finishing here tonight.
Yeah, just summed up their luck as well. Fred Barlow was game enough to take that first touch away from the defender. Had a go and was unable to get it on target. Jacqueline Tran Van of OFC TV is with Reginald Devani, the assistant coach of Papua New Guinea.
Reggie, a fine 2-0 victory for your side in your opening match at the Under-20 Championship here in Suva. Are you happy with that performance?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. Always good to get a win at the start. Boys worked hard, but, you know, fortunate there as well to get the win at the end. So, but good effort from the boys.
So two set pieces were the result. What you got the goals from? Is that something you've been working on?
Yeah, something that we're working on, both attack and defence. You know, lucky with the second one, but you know, we'll take it.
So final match, next match, against American Samoa. How are you approaching that?
Look, another game. It's going to be hard. You know, they played well today, even though they lost. I thought they played well. It's still going to be a hard game on Sunday. And we'll take it every game as a hard game, no matter what.
All right. Thank you, Reggie.
Thank you.
What a player he was in his time for the Papua New Guinea team.
Absolutely. And also played in the Solomon Islands with COSA when they made the OFC Champions League final in 2008. They beat Waitakere 3-1 but couldn't go the whole way. A teammate of his that day was Gideon Omokirio, and he...
Gideon, unfortunately a 2-0 loss for your side out there, but they were looking quite good. Were you happy with how they performed?
Yes, actually we come very determined to win this game. Unfortunately, we went down by 2 goals. We actually missed a lot of opportunities which we supposed to convert, but it turned out to be not on our side today. But we'll go back to the drawing board and playing field. Training to sort out some of the mistakes and work on our to improve on our training.
So next match on Sunday against Vanuatu, who we saw in a tough match against New Caledonia, but they did get that 1-0 win. They play a similar style to Solomon Islands, I guess, with the tricky footwork. How are you going to counter that?
Yes, we've watched them today during the game, and we will go back and train. And actually, we will be doing our game plan and play our own game against them.
Great, thank you.
So Gideon Omokirio with his view of tonight's game. That concludes coverage of the match day one for the OFC U20 Championship here at ANZ Stadium in Suva, Fiji. It's been a privilege to describe the action for you. I'm Gordon Watson, and on behalf of my co-commentator, Indra Singh, and also Raymond Stoddart, we'll wish you a very good evening, and we'll see you again on Sunday for match day two.